The title of this sermon is, "The Treasury Using Bailout Funds to Increase Foreclosure Prevention, as Congress intended." 2 days ago, Secretary Paulson gave his answer. Now, Secretary Paulson's policy reversal breaks with congressional intent, contradicts public assurances previously made by the Treasury, and leads to federal government without an adequate mechanism to stem the tide of loan foreclosures. Congress is in fact enacting the Emergency Economic Stabilization Act of 2008. The statute that created the troubled asset relief program was in part to buy troubled mortgage assets and implement a plan to minimize risk for foreclosures. Only 3 weeks ago, Mr. Taxpayer testified before the Senate that he was preparing to purchase troubled mortgage assets. 2 weeks ago, Mr. Taxpayer's top staff included an individual with a position entitled Bureau Chief for Fund Preservation, another charge of loan mortgage loan acquisition, spoke with my staff about the troubled asset relief program. Plans to purchase mortgage and troubled mortgage assets. Last week, the Treasury filed a government charge report requiring that the Emergency Economic Stabilization Act, stating that Treasury's policy teams were still committed to preserving loan ownership. Rather than prevent foreclosures by acquiring troubled mortgage assets, as the Emergency Economic Stabilization Act authorized, Secretary Paulson announced on Wednesday that the troubled asset relief program would not fund mortgage assets. Instead, Treasury would exclusively continue the loan with that of providing preferred equity injections to nonprofit companies. Thus, the only significant news by Treasury of the funds Congress authorized to address the mortgage crisis underlying the financial crisis includes, among other things, propping up the federal loans program, subsidizing the evisceration of the National Savings Bank, and the layoff of thousands of trade leaders in Brazil, and indirectly funding the payment of bonuses, compensation, and dividends by financial firms and a program that is afforded to hedge fund without the TARP capital infusion. And it is very obvious that Congress would have never passed the Emergency Economic Stabilization Act, had it known how Treasury would launch the resources it was given. There's consensus among the business community, academics, and policymakers that the financial crisis will not be resolved until the mortgage crisis is resolved. There is a further consensus from experts, some of them are from today, that resolution of the mortgage crisis demands stronger action by the federal government than private industry so far as we're willing to undertake. The Emergency Economic Stabilization Act enables Treasury to purchase and thereby control the mortgage servicing of potentially millions of mortgages that will soon go into default. That control of exercise
would make a qualitative difference in kind of loan modification. And would the firm, because the federal government would not contribute to follow the same restricted loan modification process so far pursued by private investors to accomplish the social policy of protecting neighborhoods and preserving the financial system as a whole. Let's talk about the mortgage loan bonds acquired from a bank refinancing, securitized mortgage bonds. TARP could direct mortgage services to make loan modifications and increase the balance of credit mortgages. Earlier today, the industry and economic experts alike about how critical this sector is to fix up the mortgage crisis. While the sector's agreement with experts, where the Treasury currently possesses sufficient authority to purchase mortgages and affect money modifications, but the full range of mortgage and mortgage-related assets. In our last edition of the Treasury, said question, the mortgage guarantee program will replace a complement of asset purchase to the modification program. This second proposal to other 40 should not have to be made from the effect. Treasury was uniquely involved by Congress and positioned to provide a range of foreclosure prevention efforts that would not be undertaken by the private sector. Treasury had the money and the technical challenges, had solutions. Rather than perpetrate this difficult and crucial work, the Treasury Department has abdicated its responsibility to set the time of its proposals and cross the responsibility back to the private sector. And additionally, I think that there are hardworking and well-intentioned people in the industry struggling to do loan applications. There are two things. If they are not keeping up with the number of borrowers in the applications to prevent foreclosures and default, it's a predictable result. Foreclosures yet continue to mount. And millions more are under forecast. Furthermore, experience is showing that there is a significant problem of reach of loan where borrowers who are even looking to receive a loan application loan are not receiving loan applications that cure the total problems of foreclosures and debt equity. Foreclosure is the right way to run. Treasury is an action to abandon the credit for mortgage assets. Unfortunately, many tragically leads to problem of negative equity and result. Our objective is to improve the odds to have a thorough examination of the basis for the Treasury Department's decision to allow you to foreclose a prevention objective on the 12 asset loan program. As Congress may have seen this due to the request for a second installment of $450 million towards the Trump Civil Asset Relief Program. As we all know, even the new administration will try the opportunity to consider Secretary Paulson's decision. We can offer members of Congress of the next administration to understand the viewpoints and assess the judgment of the current Trump Asset Relief Program management before deciding to entrust them to handle the bailout funds and consider their policies. This time, I am pleased to recognize the distinguished gentleman from the state of California, Mr. Garrison, who is the legislative ranking member of the Subcommittee of the Planning Board, expressing concern over so many of these issues that are reflected by the understanding of the Treasury's management of funding. So I say this morning, thank you personally for the efforts that you have made and the work that you have done. Thank you. Which ultimately could not have been crisis as described, because the money was not in any way Thank you. October 6, 2019. Thank you. establishes a clear lines, requires federal services, and districts and counselors to help settle the lives before the end of the claims. In coordinated industry-wide action, compare the significant increase in outreach and assistance provided to homeowners. But now this is the goal, Secretary Paulson outlined three critical priorities for the main strategies for the most effective deployment of remaining TARP funds. Number one, greater strengthening the capitalness of our financial system. Number two, supporting the asset-backed securitization market that is critical to consumer finance. And number three, increasing foreclosure mitigation efforts. These priorities are necessary to reinforce the stability of our financial system, so that banks and other institutions critical to the provision of credit are able to support the economic recovery and growth and the homeowners of our foreclosure. The conclusion of our system is stronger and more stable than it was just a few weeks ago. Although more has been accomplished, we have no challenges ahead of us. We will focus on the goals outlined by Secretary Paulson and develop the right strategies to meet those objectives. Thank you. So, Thank you. Thank you. fairness hearings. I was not put myself in a position that my constituents would like to this. Because when I came on, I was not going to have a mouthful of coffee there. I would be a fair burden on you to believe me. When I got a super coffee tonight, when I go check my blog and the business statement, I promise you people are going to ask me a question. The work that I said is comments. You guys should hear it. We can't get back this time. But I'm losing my house today. And you're going to ask the question back. And I said, well, we've got about 7 days. We have got about 3 months to go out. If not, we can get up. And we work that back this time. And now we've been trying to set our bed off. We can be trying to get back. I do not want to hear about it. I just want to hear about the private movements. I just want to hear because this administration and this process has put me in a position where I don't have a job. I'm not going to work in a part-time job. So I'm going to have this something that is waiting for the time to die and I'm going to say something that I'm going to I'm going to take a picture of it. I'm going to steal my money. And I'm going to work with someone like this in that it's not care for things like this firm. Let's just get the best ideas to try to make it work for the right people. Right? This is a proportion of the firm, not the head of the firm, not the firm, not the firm. So, statistics, but the real firm modifications of the first day, you know, we're going to take the rent, the firm wasn't the start of this year. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. restricted share purchases as it makes sense based on that capital rate. And they have to pay out to the shareholders. So now the time that was made to pay out, in favor that that money could not be, they want to return to the company and to their base to earn the money to themselves to make them work for it. And at the same time, it's not going to happen anyway because there's still a lack of confidence in our economy and our system. So we believe that the economic incentives will be there. They're very strong. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. I'm just going to go ahead and get out of here. refer to the data as that of the witnesses in a second letter. Thank you. dynamics, Mr. Chairman. Thank you. these trusts or those investors were concerned that they were conserving their ownership and that this is systemic risk in the economy. Thank you for allowing us to make sure it's possible. Profit from lending fees are keeping borrowers in this tax of default. Tax rate Thank you. This section provides that the Secretary has the right guarantees and equipment and access to facilitate loan modifications to prevent the loan foreclosures. The loan guarantee program required that covers specific loans that have been modified. This can result in loan modifications. A multiple loan modification program assumes it takes the following steps. First, the specific proposed loan modification is designed based on the borrower's current bonding plan. Second, the anticipated payment stream from that loan that is modified is compared with the anticipated recovery from foreclosure on a net present value basis. And third, the servicer chooses the alternative with the greater liability. Not comparing the loan modification with foreclosure, the servicer applies an assumed rate lock rate, and this factor reduces the NPV of the modification alternative. Case for the private sector loan modification initiatives do not. The primary, the just earlier today, we're looking at running a reference to the industry and I want to work together with the firm to talk about the advantage of the firm owners and simultaneously help them get a strong credit and money to others. The economic and housing market conditions are clearly deteriorating with the rise of demands and opportunity issues in Pennsylvania recently. John Ross is declining from the buyers, and Ross is from the high value market to sell against the client of that severe strain. Since the TARP program announced, it continues to be a great demonstration of what the virtual economy can do without a great basis the program will purchase, and how that will also prevent the federal government from selling this service and its assets. If all laws are purchased by TARP and workers in the banks, for example, the government would have to pay this person to apply it to all laws mitigation and all modification for all costs for these loans. If the TARP program was to buy mortgage backed securities as well, their ability to exercise control over service and policy to affect the rate the program purchased a supermajority Securities. It doesn't affect us directly, and we're going to get a basis Not the securities, but Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. This discussion has been on the next question. The Treasury Using Bailout Funds to Increase Foreclosure Prevention. That's how you should tell. We've got witnesses from Mr. Matthews Garner, Assistant Secretary of the Treasury for Financial Stability, Assistant Secretary of Treasury for International Financial Development, and we much appreciate his participation today, as well as the second panel, Professor Michael Burnett, Professor Matthews.